Hello everyone again. I thought today I'll do something different and do my first commentated Doomtown video. This is a match I just played of Fourth Ring versus Morgan. And I have no idea what I'm facing. I'm expecting dudes and teeth because I don't see any shooters. And we're going quickly into the game. This is a bit after it started. My opponent has already started equipping his Travis Moon, which I'm a bit surprised because Travis Moon is very expendable. On the good side, I got a pretty good hunt. I got two spells that I can use and two expendable dudes. I don't want to play them both though because they were going to eat all my money up. So instead I decide to go in and use my blood curse and try to swap some cards and see what I'm going to do yet. I don't want to get rid of hex slinging because I might get into a fight, so I discard Steven Wiles because I can play Bobo from my hand with my spell if I need to. I play a second blood curse on my Mikarize and the Raising Hell while my opponent keeps passing. He didn't get any money and so I didn't either, so I'm happy about that. And I decide to discard Bobo at the end of the turn because I can get him back with Hell Raising. I really need to find some deals. Instead I draw two more Hexlinging and one taking out with me, which kinda forces me to go and fight this turn to get my hand clean. I get another full house, another two pair sitting, so he wins lowball again. He basically is going to be winning almost all lowballs this game. I have quite a good amount of money, so does he. So he used the opportunity to play his Circle and Runs. I'm expecting that he has something else to play, that's why he didn't use his ability. But in retrospect he may have forgotten, I'm not sure. Or he may not have wanted to give me any free kills. In any case, I won't let him draw a card. So I'm just sending my Steel Archer over there to take control and just deny him the extra card this turn. He used the opportunity to take money out of Steel Archer. That a lawyer is very annoying when you have a lot of influence. And then he brings Irving Patterson unbooted. I'm suspecting a pistol whip is incoming. So I bring Mikarize as a backup so that I have at least one of them unbooted afterwards. I'm feeling fairly secure with my hex slingings. I'm expecting he would pistol whip Travis Moon so that I don't have any good bullets, and that he will bring Travis Moon in for a backup. Unfortunately for me, he decides to piece with Mikarize, which allows me to only play a single Hexling in this turn if I need to. Which is unfortunate. I would have liked to play both if the situation required it. I'm passing because I'm expecting Travis Moon to join the shootout. So now that he's in, I use my blood curse and to make him very low bullets and swap one of my hexlings that I can use, and I throw a joker, which I also cannot use. He follows up with a sign in my eyes on my Travis, so we're both fighting on equal ground pretty much, so two zero bullets on each side. I have the advantage of the hex slinging and the taking out with me if I even end up losing like this. So I don't expect to lose by too much. Unfortunately my hand is really bad. I only get one pair of queens and they're cheating as well. So I change one card and don't get anything else. So I simply get my one cheating pair. At this point the opponent plays a bit fast and tries to discard his blue tick. Before I had a chance to play my resolutions. So he remembers afterwards, he's telling me he keeps forgetting a few stuff this game. So unfortunately I also reminded him to play a coach whip, which is bad, but I still have Travis, and he was cheating, so I still have Travis in to take the hit, And I managed to cause two casualties, which will force his Travis Moon to get discarded as well. And his blue tick. So, about as equal fight, with both zero draws now. And I'm hoping he will decide to run away, because it seems that I'm putting in better hands in Lobul than he does. Of course, if he didn't run away, I would, because I don't want to lose my Huckster. If I was in his situation, I would stay and then just try to scare me away. But as it happens, I get to keep control of it. It is fine by me. I discard my my dude. I play my dude, so I have a bit of influence and I can stop his production, and that I can actually get my hired guns down. So I'm going to swap positions. I'm going to put Steel Archer back home so that he doesn't get two Ghost Rockets turned from his lawyer, and instead I'm going to use Mikarize to move to his mine. So that he doesn't get any production next turn. He should have sent Clementine Lep over there to deny, to still be able to get production. But it's a small thing anyway. I get finally some deeds. Unfortunately, I have so little money I can only play one of them. And I keep losing Lobul, so that doesn't allow me to do anything else with this. My only option next turn is to play the patch perch, and then play the patch perch, and then use my ability to get one ghost rock and play the pharmacy. So that's my plan for next turn. Of course, depends on what my opponent is going to do. Seems that he's taking a while to think about it. So I'm in a really good situation here. He doesn't have any shooters. And I have Clint Ramsey, who is sitting there denying him his money. So I really want to get my production going, so I'm going to put the patch perch, and then I'm going to see if I can bring down that pharmacy. But I have to succeed on a spell. However, now that he brings a shooter, I'm not feeling very comfortable about that. About that one. So I'm going to use my my hard guns to get my Bobo in, so I have a second shooter for this upcoming fight, and I can also use then his runs to draw a card. Of course, that takes me quite low on money, but I have to do it, or he's just going to have too much firepower for one man to handle, especially since I know he's running shootout actions. He decides to bring a second dude in. I bring my Bobo in, so I now have a good, a decent amount of firepower to use with my dudes. I'm still expecting quite a lot of shootout actions from on his end. But fortunately, he doesn't. You will see how much he has. So Bob is coming over there. He's calling me out. I accept, of course. And Bob is going to jump in and help. So I have a significant advantage in the shooter. I have one more stud bullet on my shooter, and my second guy is a stud. He goes ahead and plays a pin down, which I suspect he did it in case we tied or he wins, that I have to lose Clint Ramsey first instead of Bobo, which is fair enough. I would have played the Bobo anyway to have a better chance of winning, but that works. Unfortunately, I can't get any very good hand. I only get a four of a kind cheating. I was hoping to get something legal, because I know he's packing snake bite, which is not very good when I'm trying to avoid casualties. But I keep reading and reading my cards, and I just don't see anything better than full house, four of a kind cheating. So I'm going to go with that. I'm kind of afraid he's going to play a nasty anti-cheating and reduce my hand rank. But even if he plays a code sweep, I'm still only going to lose Bobo, which I can still bring back with my Raising Hell, so it's not a huge deal. Okay, so there we go, we reveal our hands, and he only has a 3 of a kind, and I have a cheating 4 of a kind. So, it is quite nice, I get to kill both of his dudes. Pity I didn't get to my Undertaker already, that would have been quite a lot of money in the last few turns. But I get to keep Bobo, I get to keep all my dudes, and he lost 9 Ghost Rock for no reason. Finally, my Undertaker comes. Unfortunately, I don't have nearly enough money to be able to play it, but I can get rid of my Pharmacy and try to play the Undertaker later. I'm going to bring Mika Rise over, because I want him to be able to use a Blood Curse and maybe try to swap one of my deeds and get some money. I'm considering a bit if I want to put him in the town square, but I decide not to because next turn I would have to take an action to move to his deed after Bobo is discarded. And unfortunately my spell pool failed, so I don't get to discard my card. So I'm instead moving I'm moving Clint over to his mind to keep denying him his production. Again, he should have probably moved somebody to my mind to deny my production and split my dudes up, but he doesn't. And I discard and I get a pretty good hand. I get finally some cheap production plus the recruitment drive, which he used to get my Undertaker in for cheap. He gets the 2 pairs, I also get the 2 pairs and I have a higher value, so he wins once more. I'm a bit complaining that I just can't win any lowballs. But it's okay, the rest of the game is going pretty well for me, so I can't really complain too much. So now it depends on what he's going to do. I'm planning to do a spell and then play my Undertaker, but playing that Steven Wild changes things. He has now a lot of influence on the table, and if I do my recruitment drive and succeeds and get my Undertaker in, all that will do is that he will go and take over everything, and if he plays one more control point, it might cost me the game. So I decide that I will probably want to play it safe. So I'm going to start by reducing the bullets of his Steven Wilds, so that he gets, if he wants to build any deeds, it's not as a chip. And I may be able to replace one card. So I get to hit him. I'm deciding what I want to discard. I'm going to go for the Undertaker. This way, when I get, can't take it this turn. So if my recruitment drive fails, I'll be out of Undertaker again, but I don't expected my recruitment drive will fail because I have a pretty good shooter, so I want to bait him to come over and then I will run away and see if I can do my recruitment drive. So he puts a shotgun on Steven Wallace, which I didn't appreciate, and that means I cannot do the recruitment drive with Mika because he's just going to come in a shotgun into the face. So I decided to just play my deed. I'm not even going to try to do the recruitment drive yet. So I'm going to pass. I'm going to see how he goes to take over his deeds. He's probably going to come over, then he does, and I'm going to use the ability of Mika to simply run away unbooted, so that I may be able to do the recruitment drive from the mine. So now I'm just passing to see what he's going to do. Expect him to maybe trade that goods back so that he doesn't lose the shotgun when Steven Wild leaves. That's some expensive piece of equipment. Unfortunately, he passes, but I suspect he didn't realize he could trade the shotgun. So I remind him that he can actually save the shotgun if he moves back home. The smart way, of course, would be to bring one of his dudes to the mine and give the shotgun there, so that Steven Wilds still protects the mine. But since he boots Steven Wilds home, this gives me a good opportunity to get my recruitment drive. He realizes I played him a bit. So he doesn't defend, he doesn't really have any way to defend against the three stud effectively. So I'm going to get finally my Undertaker out, which is good because it allows me my deck to follow the combo it has going. So we go, finally got my Undertaker in. So now my Raising Hell and everything is a bit more powerful. He should have used this opportunity to go and control some of my stuff, just to make sure I don't get a lot of money. But he decided not to. So that's fine with me. I'm suspecting the other player is a bit tired, doesn't really play optimally. But still, I mean, the game progress is fine, so it's not a huge deal. This is the kind of opportunity that you always should take, that you, when you see your opponent's shooters booted, you should always use your influence to take over his stuff, so that next turn he doesn't get a lot of money. Especially when I'm down to zero, keeping me poor would be really important next turn. So he wins swap keep once more. So this time I have a pretty decent production, so I gain 5 Ghost Rock effectively. And I have just enough to bring Tixalclanac in the game. He gets his own production going, but that's good enough for me. I'm going to move Clint Ramsey to take over his runs before he gets a chance to use it. So he's going to go over there, take control of that, so he doesn't get to draw a card. He's playing some pretty expensive deeds. I still don't understand why he doesn't use his ability. He hasn't used the whole game. Again, he's probably just tired and doesn't really think about it. So always, especially for out of town deeds, it's a very good idea to use your ability to get some money. Of course, in this case, he I could have called him out with Mika, which he could have avoided, of course, by playing first the Mustang and then bringing out the mine. And if Mika came to call him out, he would just run away. So finally, I got my Shadow Walk. So if he pistol with Mika, Mika can come back without issues, which is really important, especially when I'm holding Hexlinging. He uses the Mustang to go over to my Undertaker, which I don't understand because he could have just walked through it. Again, it's probably if you have the opportunity to move through the town center, just do that. There's no point in rushing. The Undertaker doesn't really have an ability that you are in a rush to use. So in this situation, he could have simply moved to the town square and then moved to the Undertaker, and he would have been just fine and kept his Mustang available. So now I'm bringing Ticks. I have enough money. I'm going to use Ticks to clear out him from my Undertaker. He's acting like he's panicking from Ticks. So I think at the moment the game is pretty much closing for him. He doesn't have any good shooters, and I'm controlling pretty much everything. So he comes to the town square. I expect he might have some trick up his sleeve. I don't want to take any chances. So I'm going to use the opportunity to Blood Curse here, so which will make her 0/0 again, and this will allow my enemy to swap a card around. Unfortunately, I keep missing the blood curses with Mika Rise. That's where the zero Huckster comes is problematic. But I can't complain too much. It wouldn't make much of a difference. I would have just cleared out one of my taking a weakness. Still, I get to draw a card. I get another spell. Now I can give something to Steel Archer to do. And he's parking over at my Undertaker. I suspect he's holding pistol whips, and he may try to bait one of my hucksters into the Undertaker to kill. So I'm not going to take the bait. I'm instead just going to deny him production as long as I don't want to fight. Him controlling the Undertaker is not a problem for me. So I'm just going to take Mika Rise over to his strike and take it over so that he doesn't have any production. So he's going to bring Clementine. I'm curious why, because he cannot actually shotgun Mika. So that's fine with me. I'm going to use Tixaclanac to clear out my Undertaker now, since he doesn't have a shooter, and at worst, he will pistol whip Tixaclanac, at which point I can bring Clint Ramsey to kill him. So that's fine, if he wants to pistol whip Tixaclanac and lose a card, I don't care. Tixaclanac is only zero influence anyway. He's just going to see what I'm going to do, so I'll simply call him out. Maybe he expected my Huckster to come, in which case he might be able to kill him with his zero draw. But he just declines the shootout. Here I did a mistake. I bring Tixaclanac to the town center when I should have brought him over to the mine to kill Clementine. So now I have instead to bring Clint Ramsey to the mine to kill Clementine. And that makes me boot my dudes around. But it's not a big deal anyway. It doesn't really change much. And at least I will have Tixaclanac there to control the town center. Here, I'm not sure if I'm forgetting something. I don't remember any actions that are able to give plus one bullets in the shootout. I think the only thing that give plus one bullets are outside of shootouts. So I think I'm fine. I think I'm not in any danger. So I'm just going to go ahead and try and kill her. I'm pretty secure that I will be able to do it. Whatever happens, I'll be able to kill her. Question is if I have to take any casualties. But I don't suspect. He's only one draw anyway. So, yeah, there's not much to do. I'll draw 7 cards, 8 cards. Here I got a mistake. I draw 7, change 1 instead of drawing 8. Forgot that for some reason it slipped my mind that Mika is a stud, but it doesn't matter anyway, so I get a legal 3 of a kind. I don't expect her to get anything better, and if she did, I can always use my cards in my hand. So she dies, I get 2 ghost stroke from my Undertaker burying the dead. He forgot about the Undertaker, so I have to remind him here. He is down to 4 influence and I have 3 control points, so all I need is just a few more control points or kill somebody else and I can win the game. I'm going to send Mika over to his mine. I remember that he might be holding a Stephen Wallace in his hand, so I'm just going to use the Shadowwalk to allow me to swap a card as well, which effectively gives me another spell, which is excellent. So I'm going to play that as well, just in case it's ever needed. So I'm in a really powerful position. I have really good shootout stuff. I have 2 blood curses ready to go. So I'm feeling fairly secure that I'll be able to close this game soon. Finally, I win my first low ball in the game. And I also get tons of money from all the stuff I control. I decided to try another blood curse. But I'm thinking maybe I should get spells, my cards out of my hand so I can use the runs first before he has any chance to do anything else. So I also play Bobo. So I can now have a lot of good shooters. I draw a card and I draw another Hexling in. It's a bit frustrating. I keep drawing those Hexling in my hand. Fortunately, he's eager to get into shootouts, so it doesn't actually harm me. If he was avoiding shootouts, that would have actually hurt me a lot, because they would be sticking in my hand and making me very difficult to do anything. Here he does another mistake. He should have given the horse to his guy first. This way, if he would have gotten the ghost rock and been able to swap him out and save him if things went bad. But as it happens, he just has to bring him in. I remind him later once he calls me out that that was a bad idea, but he decided to stick with it instead of taking it back. So, I'm suspecting he has another pistol whip. Although in this situation where you just have another pistol whip, there's no reason why you shouldn't bring your other dudes unbooted. Putting your dudes to jump into shootouts if you have an opportunity not to is not always the best option. So I send back his Tixernagak. I think he's a bit desperate here. He doesn't really have an option to do anything else. He can send Bobo back, which would have lowered my bullets, but it would have been a marginal change. So I discard one hexlinging. Maybe I can get something useful for this turn. Instead, I get another, taking it with me. That's fine. I still have two hexlingings, and when you see your opponent discarding a hexlinging when they have three hexes, you can pretty much sure they're holding two more. They would, Huxley would never discard a hexlinging in a shootout when they're only one in their hand. Here I remind him that it's better to make Irving his shooter because Blake would still give him the shootout, the extra card. And finally get my first legal hand in the game. I get a legal full house. So finally I don't have to cheat. And he reveals a cheating full house. So I decide to simply play my two hexlingings and sacrifice some of my spells and make sure that I kill all his dudes so I can win the game. Here he didn't realize that I actually have two of them. He thought he's only one. And yeah, that's it. He sees them in my hand and gets dismayed that everybody died from Mika's. And that's game. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you had a few interesting ideas you learned on how to play the game. Always remember, try to deny your production of your opponent on any opportunity. If they're booted out, it's a perfect opportunity to just send your wimpy influence over, take over the deeds, deny them production, stop them from getting stronger next turn. You want your opponent, you want to keep hitting your opponent when they're down. And this way, your game will have a bit more leeway if it goes wrong on your end. I hope you enjoyed it, and until next time.